up your nuts and bump.
Is affirmative action on the chopping block? The Supreme Court can finally abolish the race-based practice that's been screwing over high-achieving Asian American students for decades. John Wang is one of the people suing and claims that
screwing over Asian Americans. This is America. Don't get you slipping now. Oh, how selective is the amnesia? Ladies and gentlemen, citizens of YouTube, this is what is infuriating about the selective amnesia and the fact that Caucasian America wants to truly forget about all of the foul treatment that was race-based, okay? Caucasians created the race-based issues in North America. This is America. Don't get you slipping now. USA. From slavery, Jim Crow, redlining, and still the unfair, unjust practices within the judicial system of USA. But now, an Asian American who has not only benefited from affirmative action, because let's not forget that you too were fucked over by Caucasians because you were Asian. And you benefited from the blood, sweat, and tears of so-called black people who fought for affirmative action, but now it's somehow holding you back. Let's continue.
Affirmative action is to blame for his recent rejection from top-tier colleges and universities, despite his near-perfect SAT scores. John Wang now telling a story to Laura Ingram.
The top tier schools I applied to were MIT, Caltech, Princeton, Harvard, Carnegie Mellon, and UC Berkeley. Guidance counselors, they all told me that it's like tougher to get in, like especially as an Asian American. I just took it as gospel. I had a 20% chance of gaining admission to Harvard as an Asian American, and then a 95% chance as an African American.
So where does affirmative action...
See, the problem is that they've now convoluted affirmative action and equal opportunity with this equity and inclusion bullshit that the Biden administration has brought into existence. See, equity talks about equal outcomes, which is some insane bullcrap. Affirmative action and equal opportunity says, hey, you get the equal opportunity to do the work and earn an outcome. This is the problem.
Stand right now in the court. Affirmative action is still the law of the land, okay? The problem is that we now have a world of equity where there's no real equality.
Thank you. I'm going to take it back.
In the court. Affirmative action is still the law of the land, okay? The problem is that we now have a world of equity where there's no real equality. And when what he was saying is he's got a 20% chance of getting into Harvard. If you're African American with those same numbers, you've got a 95% chance.
Now, that's important. See, because according to the story, the way that they were setting it up, it was as if the so-called black person had a lower score, but they were still afforded the opportunity to attend these colleges. No, with the same high test score, they would get in. Now, once again, you play back the films of affirmative action. Was it Asian people out there getting hosed down? Was it Asian people? Was it Latin people out there being attacked by the police dogs? Was it? I'll save you time. No, it wasn't.
wow. of getting in. I mean, the scales are so tipped.
Jesse
Waters. 5% chance
wow.
of getting in. I mean, the scales are so tipped against the qualified people in terms of, you know, kind of what are we doing? We're trying to make up for whatever happened in the past. Get over it and start all over again.
But they never say that about the Holocaust. But they never say that about these, about the Rainbow Gang. They never say that about anybody else except the things that directly affect so-called black people. And I know you people might be getting irritated because I keep stopping it. I'll attempt to let it play long.
Mm-hmm. It's taking away the incentive of people.
If you just did it by scores, only scores, would you have, what, a majority of Asian undergraduate people in Harvard?
Can I just jump in? Because
sure,
that's
please.
What Harvard did. They call it a fake study, whatever. Harvard wrote down on a piece of paper that if they were to do that, 43% of their student body would be Asian Americans. And they denying that. That's one of the key pieces of evidence in this case that has worked its way up through the Supreme Court. I think that this...
Which means that it would be 57% Caucasian?
Supreme Court, I think, is going to do away with this.
Wow.
Unfortunately for students everywhere, I think that the schools are going to find some sneaky way to get around it. They'll call it something else. They'll say that they're looking at other things. However, I think these students are going to set a precedent that's not only for colleges, but think about that school down, Thomas Jefferson High School down in Virginia.
And once again, Jesse Waters made a statement as if Asians are more intelligent and would get higher scores than so-called black people. Let me tell you something. Asians being good academically and at math is a stereotype, just like all Asians know kung fu, which is some bullshit.
When the top schools, this is also an issue for Asian Americans at that school. And those parents have banded together and said, we are not going to allow this. What I think will be very interesting when the Supreme Court decides this, it will happen first at universities, I think then to the private schools, and then what happens in corporate America.
And that was my point that I stated earlier. It is because of the total blackout, the total quote unquote blackout of all melanin-rich people, regardless of how intelligent they were, and we are very intelligent, it made it impossible to get a job because, once again, North America made everything race-based, ethnically based. Race, there's only one race, the human race.
It could be a real effect all the way down.
Mr. Greg Gutfeld, gosh, such a wang.
So, please go to the 5 Fox, watch the rest of this story. I'm quite sure that you guys are very interested. But the thing that's going to happen is that as soon as the Asians are used as a proxy to fight against affirmative action, which also benefits Asians, Latins, women, and every other so-called minority group, as soon as they get it abolished, they'll then see a yellow out, a blackout, a woman, a blocking of all other so-called minorities. And this will be the thing that will make me laugh at the same time it irritates me. And in closing, my issue is that every other minority group has appropriated affirmative action and the talks about racism and systematic racism. They've abused it. Every time you turn around, you got somebody in the Rainbow Gang, the LGBTQ people, talking about, this is racist, this is none of it, it's just like black people. They always say that until they get benefits, and then the rainbow flag comes out again. And we know that the LGBTQ community has a large number of Europeans and Caucasians in it. So this is going to be laughable. This is enough rope for you to hang yourself, because as soon as you get rid of affirmative action, your high score won't mean anything, John Wang. You won't be getting in. I'm tired of this shit. The only people that are truly deserving, because we earned it, are so-called black people in the USA. That's right, I said. And that's the truth.